Hi everyone and welcome to a quick tech tutorial from Pixamoo. Today we're going to be ranking stuff in Excel. There's been so many times in the past where I've needed to rank items in the dataset from number one to whatever based on size, weight, height, score, duration, or any other number of things. But I must have been living under a rock because it was only yesterday that I realized that Excel can do this for you with a really simple formula. I have no idea why I never thought to look into it. It randomly just came up in an email newsletter that I subscribed to, The Morning Brew. Thank you guys. The Morning Brew has nothing to do with Excel, but there it was. So anyways, here's how to rank stuff in Excel. First, you're going to need a list of things that you want to rank. In this case, we're going to rank cars based on how fast they accelerate from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour or 0 to 62 miles per hour if you're metrically challenged. So yeah, here's a list of more or less awesome cars and how fast they accelerate from 0 to 100 kilometers in seconds. Now, if you're both an Excel nerd and a rev head, go easy on me. I grabbed these numbers off the first and worst website I could find, so the numbers aren't necessarily accurate. Anyways, I'll show you how to rank things in Excel in two slightly different ways. The first one here is rank equal, and the other one is rank average. If you are into sports, you're going to like and understand rank equal. So you know how if you have two runners finish their 100 meter sprint in exactly the same time, then they'll share the rank. So equal first, for example, and the next one down after those two will be number three. That's what the rank equal function does. To do rank equal, just type in the equal sign rank.eq, or you can hit tab once the formula you want is highlighted down here to autocomplete that bit. So hit tab here and it'll put in the formula and then bracket and you're good to go. The first number you're going to select is the performance of the car on the row that you're at. So that's 2.3 seconds. Next, you're going to rank that number against all of these numbers. And you have to make that here an absolute reference, because otherwise when you copy this formula down to all the other rows, that big bracket here that you're measuring against is going to move down as well. So easiest way to make absolute references that stay the same no matter where you copy a formula is to just hit F4 like that. Now that you see dollar signs in front of $B$6 and $B$17, it means that reference will stay the same. Another comma, and now we're going to select whether to rank things in descending or ascending order. The default is descending, which you get by popping in a zero. If you do that, it will rank the biggest number as the best one. So the Volkswagen up at 15.6 seconds will be number one. In this case, obviously, faster is better, so we're going to go with ascending order, meaning the smallest number will be considered the best one. Once you've done that, round out the formula with a bracket, hit enter. Now, before you can see the rank for every single car, you just have to hit double click the little auto fill dot down here in the bottom right corner of the cell. That'll fill all the way down to the bottom of the list of numbers. And straight away now, you can see that the Saleen S7 is the fastest accelerating car from 0 to 100 kilometers in 2.2 seconds, closely followed by the Bugatti Chiron and the Porsche 911 Turbo S. In equal fourth, we have Ferrari, Lamborghini, and McLaren. So you'll see here the rank equal function has given them all an equal fourth place. And then the next car after that is the Toyota Corolla Hybrid in good company here at 10.9 seconds being number 7. And poor old Volkswagen up is number 12 down here. So that's the rank equal function. Now, if you wanted to do rank average, the only real difference here is we type rank.AVG, or when the formula you want is highlighted, just hit tab to autocomplete that bit. Once again, select the number that you want to rank, then the list of numbers you want to rank that number against. Hit F4 to make it a absolute reference, because otherwise things will get messed up. Comma, and then one for ascending. Round that out with a bracket as well and hit enter. Then we autofill by hitting the autofill dot here. And now the only difference that you'll see in this list is that Ferrari, Lamborghini, and McLaren are all equal 5, because normally they would be occupying the 4th, 5th, and 6th spot on the list. Now, if you average out 4 + 5 + 6, that becomes 5, because 4 + 5 + 6 is 15, divide that by 3 equals 5. But what if we only had 2 cars that were equally fast? So say the Lamborghini had a bad day and only managed to accelerate 0 to 100 in 3.2 seconds. Now in the rank equal list, the only difference here is that the Lamborghini then becomes number 6, while the Ferrari and the McLaren remain equal 4. Meanwhile, in the rank average list, Ferrari and McLaren become 4.5. That's because they're now occupying the 4th and the 5th spot in the list. And if you average 4 + 5, that's 4.5. So there you go, that's how we rank stuff in Excel. Now, I hope you found this quick tutorial useful, just like I had a bit of an aha moment once I read The Morning Brew and realized you can actually rank stuff easily in Excel without jumping through hoops. If you found this video useful, I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel. It's always good to have people come along for the ride. And if you have any questions or feedback about the video, hit up the comments field. I try to reply to all comments. Thanks, everyone.